In the book, I talk about inflammation and brain health. And that's kind of a theme. We all know about inflammation being a normal physiological process. If you sprain your ankle or your wrist, or if you have an infection, your inflammatory system deals with it. Those inflammatory cells will repair the damaged tissue. They will fight off the foreign body. And that's a good thing. You may feel some pain, you may have some redness on the joint, but that means your body is healing. One of the problems we see with brain aging, and actually a lot of age-related illnesses, is that the inflammatory system kind of gets into high gear. We have too much inflammation for our own good. And in fact, if you look at an Alzheimer brain, you can see evidence of inflammation. The amyloid plaques I'm going to be talking about, there's if you're a physician, you'll know about activated microglia or complement. You see that in the amyloid plaque. And I'll show you some of the studies we've done where we've actually used anti-inflammatory drugs to help with memory. And a lot of the strategies in the Alzheimer's prevention lifestyle are anti-inflammatory strategies. Getting a good night's sleep, eating omega-3 fats from fish or nuts or flaxseed, or physical exercise. These are anti-inflammatory strategies. I know when I've had a brisk swim or a jog or ridden the bicycle, I've gotten my heart pumping, I've had a good cardiovascular workout, I have less joint pain. I feel better. My mood is elevated for other reasons. But this is all your inflammatory system coming into play.